Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
The German Pinscher is a great pet because of their versatility and their temperament. My name is Valerie Shulter, and I have had German Pinschers about 10 years. I had Dobermann Pinschers for 30 years before that, and was looking for something smaller, healthier, that lived longer. And I think the German Pinscher fits that bill. So the German Pinscher is so versatile. They're the true working breed. These dogs do everything. These dogs do agility, obedience, rally, lure coursing, barn hunt, nose work. They do just about anything that you can think of. They're interested if you can do it. So our German Pinscher should be a very square, compact, elegant looking dog, but not exaggerated. So what we're looking for is a dog that is as high, tall as he is long. Moderation is the key. Not like a Doberman, which is heavier in the front and slighter in the rear. We're looking for something that is much more square. Our German Pinschers belong to the working dog group, and they are one of the smaller breeds in that group. The only other breed that is their size is their cousin, the Schnauzer. And many people believe that they should not be in the working group, that it's hard for us to be competitive in that group, but I do believe they belong in that group. They are a true working dog. They were recognized by AKC in 2003, and basically our standards are 17 to 20 inches, and anything within that would be considered normal. They are 25 to 45 pounds. The two most popular colors are black and rust, or tan markings, or red. The red do not have markings, they're solid red. But that red comes in several colors of red. It comes in a fawn, a stag, which has a little more black hairs in the red group. And then allowable color also is a blue, like a Doberman. So the German Pinschers were originally a farmer's dog. They were bred to keep the varmen out of the fields, to keep them from eating the fruits and the vegetables. But also they were bred to be family companions and guard dogs. They herded and guarded their livestock, their sheep, their horses. But this is not a dog that is left outside to guard the animals. This is a dog that is brought inside at night and lives with the family. So they are a good family companion, as well as an all-around useful dog. The German Pinschers have been around since the 1300s. They actually are a very old breed. Lots of old photographs with this breed, very popular as a farm and family dog. But it wasn't really till the late 1800s that the Schnauzer is considered the long-haired version of this breed, and the German Pinschers considered the smooth-haired version. So these dogs go back to the Schnauzers, both the standard and the giant. Also, it is believed that they have a black and tan terrier, probably somewhere back there in their lineage. So our German Pinscher actually is probably what Louis Dobermann took to make the Dobermann Pinscher. So our German Pinscher was here first. Louis Dobermann found the German Pinscher to be a good start, and other breeds were obviously used to make the Dobermann Pinscher. But our men pins are probably more closely related, because during the war we almost lost our German Pinscher. So Werner Jung actually rescued a couple of these German Pinschers, took them and hid them across the lines, and took some of the larger men pins to sustain our German Pinscher breed. So my understanding is that early the German Pinschers were what helped to derive the men pins, but the men pins are what brought back our German Pinschers when they were no longer breeding them during the war. He had to sneak the dog out of Germany because they weren't allowing them to be bred. I think the German Pinschers make an excellent service dog. We have found them to be great service dogs for PTSD, as far as knowing when a person needs comfort. They also are being used now for hearing loss for older and younger people. We are also seeing them being trained for autistic children, basically herding them, keeping the children from running away. Also seniors from running away. So I think that these dogs are being used more. We have dogs in Washington being used as cadaver search dogs. I think with their nose work has allowed them to be more noticed for their search and rescue as well. They are very biddable in wanting to train, especially for food. They are not dog aggressive typically, but they do have a high prey drive. So temperament, I think, is good. They fit well in families, they fit well with seniors. They do well with other dogs and pets in home. They do well in farms and ranches, but they do have a stubborn streak. Our puppies don't go to a home until they're 9 weeks old, because I think that the last 6 to 8 weeks in their litter is very important socialization between the puppies. So our puppies don't go to their families until they're 9 weeks old. If they're going to get their ears cropped, they'll get them cropped at that time at 9 weeks. But my dogs start out with confirmation, and as they're doing confirmation, we do obedience, we do rally, we do agility, and we basically train all the time. We are training mind games, nose work games, just socialization skills, taking them out in public, taking them to the coffee shops, letting them meet people, getting them to understand that once we walk out the front door, it doesn't belong to them. The German Pinschers are a very easy breed to care for because they are a short, glossy coat. They really don't take much care. Occasional grooming, occasional brushing. Basically, I take baby wipes and wipe them down. Even if they've been out in the dirt or the mud, it pretty much falls off. They don't need bathing every few months. I would say the hardest thing about the German Pinscher is their nails. They have hard black nails, and typically they don't get enough exercise to get those nails trimmed. Their feet should be hard, tight feet like cats, and their nails tend to grow very long. And if their nails grow long, they can't walk properly. So I would say the most important part of grooming a German Pinscher is getting their toenails done. And that's probably a weekly or bi-weekly event. German Pinschers are not big shedders. I would say they're on the scale of a light shedder. It's a short hair, so even when they shed, you don't see much of it. The only health issues facing this breed are cataracts, and they're not old age cataracts. Old age cataracts, you know, we get them. We learn to live with the losing of our sight. Typically what our dogs have is a juvenile cataract, which is a cataract that can't be seen by the naked eye. You actually, these dogs need to have eye exams every year until they're 8 years old. Other than that, we do test for hips, Von Willebrand's. Well, we are testing for echo just because of some of the problems that the Dobermans have had. We are not finding any other real health, serious health problems in our German Pinschers. They relatively are a healthy breed and live a good long life with not a lot of care. They need to be with somebody who is willing to put training and willing to put time into them. So they are not the backyard, junkyard dog, guard dog. This is not the kind of dog that you're gonna just leave in the backyard and leave for 8 hours a day and come home from work and he's gonna be fine. Once they are 2 or 3 years old, they enjoy being with their owner, but they need a walk or some activity. But it doesn't have to be strenuous activity, it just needs to be some activity. So a walk, you know, 5-6 days a week, after they are 2 or 3 years old. These are a good companion. They want to jump in the car and go to the store with you. They want to go camping with you. They want to go hiking with you. But they can lay around and watch TV all day long as they get a little bit of exercise. Bentley is 5 years old, and Bentley is one of the dogs that I bred, and he is about 19 inches tall, and he's about 44 pounds, and he's a pretty solid dog. The German Pinscher in general is a lot like Bentley in that they are a very proud dog. I think of them like a Banty rooster. They have a high head carriage typically, a very happy way of going, flat way of going, covering ground, and just a pleasure to look at as well as be around. Chevelle is on the smaller spectrum. Chevelle is about 18 inches tall. She is only about 35 pounds. She's a little more feminine, elegant size of the breed, but still within the standard. Chevelle is now over 9 years old, and Chevelle was our first dog to take to Westminster. She won the breed at Westminster in 2011. She is a bronze grand champion. She is also a UKC champion. She is an international champion. She has obedience rally, barn hunt titles as well. And she has all her Canine Good Citizen and her Trick Dog titles. She has gone on to live with an older couple who is in need of a hearing assistance dog. So Chevelle has been taught that when the doorbell rings, when their phone rings, to let them know so that they can feel safe at home alone with her. So she is quite the princess now. We take her when they're on vacations, but otherwise she will live with them as long as they need her. I'm very happy with where the German Pinschers are going. We are getting more type in our German Pinschers, getting them to look more alike. It is a little bit difficult because our German Pinschers, especially from Europe and overseas, still have tails and ears. So you don't always know that what you're looking at is a German Pinscher. Many people think they're looking at a Manchester Terrier or some other breed. I think there's a lot of people out there that could live with this breed and be very happy. And one of my favorite things about this breed is that they live a long time. I know many of these German Pinschers that are 16, 17 years old and still pretty happy and healthy. So anytime we can keep a breed that long, that's a good breed.